Hey, what is up guys? Welcome back to another video where today we are going to be ranking the three John Wick movies. I went to see the third one on Saturday, and so I thought I'd put out the ranking as I said in my last video. And I have to say with this franchise, it's really hard for me to state reasons why I like one over the other because all three of them are just so great. So it's really hard. I can give a reason why I enjoy like my first place pick more than the second and third pick that I have on this list. But let's jump right into this ranking with number three. All right, so coming in last place is John Wick 2. Now, like I said before, I can't really give reasons why I like one over the other. But for this, let's just start off with what I think is great about them. For one, there's just Keanu Reeves. Keanu Reeves, in all these films, he had to learn how to do this. He got trained to do this, to learn how to, like, reload the guns as fast as he does. He's not really shooting people, but he learned, like, how to use them. The hand-to-hand fighting in this is really, really good. It's so awesome. Like, the gunfights are really awesome, and you gotta give credit to Keanu Reeves for that. And he's also just a really good John Wick. Like, he's also just a really good character, too. I do think this has a more complex story than the first one, because the first one for me had a very simple story, where, which we'll talk about when we get to that one, and this one had a more complex story where it, talks about blood oaths, and it goes more into, like, the world of John Wick. I thought it was really cool, like, the world of John Wick, like, the way, like, the rules, like, everything, like, it was really cool. Like, it's interesting to learn about this world, too. It's all really good. And they leave you on a pretty good cliffhanger at the end of this that sets up the third one. And it's a pretty good cliffhanger. And, yeah. I think that's all I got to talk about. Just because I'm trying to keep this short. So, yeah. I think this is a very diverse opinion because a lot of people think the second one's the best. Some in the middle. But John Wick movies are always divisive for some people. So yeah, let's move to number two. Coming in second place is the original John Wick. So I actually think I can give a reason why I like the first one over the second one, and that is because it was the original John Wick. It was the one to introduce us to John Wick, what kind of action we were going to get, and it was really good. This movie, I will say, has a simpler story. It just has John Wick, his wife died, these guys want his car, so they come to his house, steal his car, and kill his dog. That was an adorable puppy, by the way. That was one of the things I didn't like about the film. But I get why they did it. And so John Wick goes on a rampage to kill him. It's a very more simple story, which on paper sounds really bad. It doesn't sound like a good story, but the way they show it in the movie, they make you sympathize with John Wick and makes you root for John Wick to kill Yosef. And also, there's just the action itself. The action itself is so satisfying in this movie. Like, in John Wick 2, like, there was some new action, but a lot of it was some of the stuff we saw in John Wick 1. This was the first time we saw it. And it was so cool to see these, because, like I said, Keanu Reeves does his own stunts. He had to train for this. And it's just more satisfying. There's no, like, not like the Marvel movies where they try to do hand-to-hand fights. There's all kinds of quick cuts. Not in this film. There's tons of long takes. We can see it's Keanu Reeves. Just the action is insane. I found in this movie the gunfights to be a lot stronger in this movie than the hand-to-hand fights. I found the hand-to-hand fights better in John Wick 2, but in this movie, the gunfights were really awesome. And this is still a really good movie. I can rewatch this one lots too, like I could for the second one. And with that, let's move to number one. But in first place is John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum. Now, going into this film, like, coming off of the second one, which has insane action, I was expecting the action to be great in this film. But surprisingly, this film was able to surpass the action in both the first two John Wicks combined. That is the main thing of this movie, is the action. The action is so unique in this movie. They have unique locations. Like, there's one fight that takes place in a knife museum, which is my personal favorite fight. There's a scene where these guys chase after John Wick when he's riding a horse. They chase after him on motorbikes. There's a whole motorbike chase scene. Like, it is so awesome. Like, the action in this movie was choreographed so well, I could watch these fights all day. Like, I will say, like, watching this film, the film, it was a lot bloodier than the first two. It is definitely is noticeable, which is fine for the most part, but sometimes you need to turn away from the action. Especially during the knife fight. There is a scene in the knife fight where John Wick's like about to stab someone in the eye. And in most films, they cut away. They do not cut away in this film. They show you in detail what happens. That's the one kill I like had to shield my eyes. Like the audience like that theater I was in was like, whoa! Like that happened multiple times through the theater. And overall, just all the action in this film was just solid. I also think they upgraded the gunplay in this movie, too. Like, the long takes, like, I can't remember what this place is called, but it's with Sophia. She was a new character. They had this long gunfight. It was so awesome. They're also doing lots of other stuff. Like, they're having horses in these action scenes. They have dogs in this. And, like, you gotta think, how do they do this? How do they do this? Like, do they get it to work? And that's just the action alone. There's also just Keanu Reeves again. This is, I think, the best performance he's given as John Wick. He's just such an awesome character. Like, he's insane. And also, I feel like this has a lot more complex, or it has a simple story just with super complex layers. Like, the story is because of the second movie, he shot someone at the end on continental grounds, which is one of the rules they have that you can't. So because he did that, he's excommunicado or excommunicano, so they gotta kill him. Well, I feel like there's a part of the movie where he's trying to escape New York, but then they go down to like some history he has with the characters, and I felt like they kept adding more and more layers to it, which was okay, but I felt like they went a little too complex with like the like rules of the High Table. But like I think that's all I need to say right now. This is a more of a mini review too, and this is my favorite John Wick film, and I think this will definitely have a spot on my favorite movie, one of my favorite movies of the year. That is a video I'll be making at the end of this year, by the way. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Comment down below what you thought was the best John Wick. And tell me if you agree or disagree. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good day.